Hey guys, I'm Jared, and today we're talking about what's new in board gaming as of April 2nd, 2021. I'll be covering the latest news, announcements, most played games, hot new Kickstarters and crowdfunded games, and more related to board gaming for the past 2 weeks. At the end, I'll also be sharing what's going on behind the scenes with my YouTube channel, Meeple Mentor. So stick around, we've got a lot to cover. Leave me a like and comment on what kinds of updates that you want to hear more about to make sure you don't miss my news updates, new video tutorials, and our podcast episodes. Subscribe on YouTube and your preferred streaming platform. Crowdfunding on GameFound.com is the collector's edition of Robinson Crusoe by Ignacy Trzewiczyk. While it's had two editions so far, this new version includes a base camp miniature that is assembled in pieces as you upgrade your camp. They're including a volcano dice tower, a horror scenario, a caves expansion, and much more. Plus, if you already own the second edition, you can back for just the upgrades and collector's edition additions to make sure your copy is complete. You have 10 days left to back it. Over on Kickstarter, check out Fjords, a Grail game, which is a full reprint and upgraded version of the 2005 game. It's been redesigned with help from Phil Walker Harding and promises to be a beautiful new experience. The first half of the game plays as a tile-laying game, while the second half becomes area control. If you're interested, you have 10 more days to join in. A new card game for 1 to 2 players is being funded on Kickstarter called 1815 Scum of the Earth. The game recreates the historical Battle of Waterloo and looks promising. The campaign has funded and you can join before it closes on April 16th. Another card game called Foul Play, Once Upon a Crime, is out on Kickstarter now and fully funded. It's a murder mystery card game which has popular fairy tale characters as suspects. One of the good guys has gone bad and killed the bad fairy. It has 2 game modes and plays 2 to 5 players in 30 minutes. The campaign closes on April 18th. Ending soon this Monday is a flower gardening game called Floriferous. It's touted as a relaxing, easy-to-learn game about collecting flowers and making arrangements and cards with them. Will it be the next Mariposas or Photosynthesis with a relaxing nature theme? We'll have to see. It's already funded on Kickstarter, so that's a good sign. Final Frontier Games has a double feature Kickstarter campaign running right now for 2 games together, although you can opt to back just one. The Girl Who Made the Stars is a beautifully illustrated worker placement and tile-laying puzzle game for 1 to 4 players based on a San African myth about how the Milky Way galaxy and stars were created. Draw constellations on the Earth, gather resources, direct the light, and boost your standing and reputation in the village to win. In the same theme of the night sky and constellations is their game Solani. Solani is an abstract tile-laying and drafting game for 1 to 4 players. Assemble constellations in the sky, connect them, and observe the planets, then correctly identify the placement of stars and planets to complete the puzzles. Each player will have their own boards to assemble. Both Solani and Girl Who Made the Stars are $49 for backers. The campaign ends on the 13th. For 2 to 4 players, check out the new vampire game, Dracula Walpurgis Night. In this game, the players are servants or familiars of Dracula doing his bidding. He's tasked you with picking up the guests to come to his castle, and take his vampires via coffin to their destinations as well. The game plays in 1 hour, and you can back it until April 12th. For more creatures that go bump in the night, check out Boogeyman the Board Game. On Kickstarter now until the 16th, play solo, competitive, or cooperatively to survive the long night. 1 to 7 players are kids trying to survive the night and avoid the psychotic babysitter. There's all kinds of references to various horror movies throughout, and some pretty cool artwork to go with it. Plays in about 1.5 hours and for ages 13 and up. On the lighter fare, try Nutty Squirrels of the Oakwood Forest. It's a quick 1 to 6 player strategic press your luck game. Each game plays different since you build out the tree with cards. gather and carry acorns, equip and combine powers and abilities, and avoid hazards like broken branches. Plays in 15 to 45 minutes depending on player count. Sentinels of the Multiverse Definitive Edition is now running their Kickstarter campaign for the next 3 weeks for the Definitive Edition. For 1 to 5 players, control heroes fighting evil villains in a dynamic environment. All the scenarios and stories are taken from the pages of Sentinel Comics. Now for games on Kickstarter ending in a week or less, for 2 to 6 players, how about a cooperative card drafting game called Robots 8-Hour Pizza? Solve a series of tasks, and depending on your performance, completing them each round, the robots will eat some of your pizza. After 4 tasks, see how much pizza you still have left. The game plays in 20 minutes and is also scalable in difficulty for more strategic gamers. The campaign ends on the 7th. Ending on April 8th is a high fantasy deck building game called Crane Fractured Empire. It boasts limitless strategy and replayability with simultaneous card play. The goal is to build the strongest army and defeat the other players. For 1 to 6 players and plays in 45 minutes to an hour. From Rampage Games, check out Pocket Pixel Artist and Swear Mints. These two games both come in tin cans the size of mint cans. In Pixel Artist, use cubes to try to build renditions of everyday objects as determined by the cards drawn. In Swear Mints, mix and match words to make new slang and phrases. Then from the crazy word combos, come up with the funniest definition you can. Swear Mints will also offer a Kickstarter exclusive black box edition where there's more adult content and drinking rules. Both games close their campaign on April 7th. The original transparent card building game Gloom has a sequel on Kickstarter right now, Gloomier: A Night at Hemlock Hall. It's a standalone storytelling sequel with a campaign mini expansion included. 2 to 5 players compete to make their characters suffer the greatest tragedies possible before dying. Whoever has the most negative score wins. There's more to it, so you've got less than a week to back it. If you're not too squeamish, look at the funny and cute game of Cuddly Cockroaches. In the game, neighbors in an apartment building infest each other with roaches to try to avoid getting fumigated. Apparently, the idea came from a real-life scenario during quarantine. It's for 2 to 5 players and is $29 on Kickstarter for the next week. The GAMA, or Gamma Expo Online, was this month, which is the Game Manufacturers Association, the largest gathering of hobby game industry professionals in the US. It's a members-only trade show lasting several days. The 2021 Power Retail Award was given to every GAMA retailer member, so they can all say they were 2021 Retailer of the Year. Much of this is due to the hardships the retailers suffered through during the 2020 COVID-19 pandemic. Board Gaming with Education, or BGE, was awarded the Innovation in Games Award for its impact in online resources for board games as learning tools. The GAMA Wholesale Division re-elected Cito Sanchez, president of Peach State Hobby Distribution, as the GAMA Wholesale Division Chair. Additionally, Will Nibling was awarded the Rick Loomis Service Award. The web-based point-of-sale system Crystal Commerce has announced a new affiliate network for retailers using the service. It's called Infinite Allies and allows retailers to offer inventory being sold by other retailers in the network and have their inventory appear in other retailers' online stores. The referring network will get 5% of the sales. This will be very good for gamers and is a great precedent for online retailers going forward. Hopefully more collaboration will happen like this for an easier shopping experience for gamers. Asynchron Games will be getting English editions of their board games distributed in North America thanks to a distribution deal made with Ares Games. Fife French will be back in the US with a new edition featuring a new board and rules. Expect it to arrive in May. Always from Asmodee are new game announcements. Let's look at one that came out today, Square Meal. It's a puzzle-solving game from Fantasio Games where players flip, rotate, and overlap ingredient cards to solve puzzles. Complete challenges quickly and do the next puzzle. Lose points when skipping a puzzle. The game ends once the deck runs out. for 1 to 8 players ages 8 and up and plays in about 15 minutes. Retails for $20 today. Another small game called Little Factory is coming this year from Yellow USA for 2 to 4 players ages 10 and up. Players produce or trade resources to gain more valuable ones, construct buildings to gain new resources and gain points. Looks to be a solid resource management game, expected to come out this summer for $19.99. AEG will be releasing a push your luck card sequencing game on August 20th called 10. Pick up cards one at a time to gain as many as possible without exceeding a value of 10 on all the cards. Build the longest number sequence in each color and use wild cards to fill in the sequence gaps. Plays 1 to 5 players in 15 to 30 minutes. Steamforge Games will be releasing a Sonic card game this year, which is yet another video game license they've obtained for a tabletop adaptation. Sonic the Card Game is a racing game where you compete to collect power-ups and rings. Steamforge also announced Epic Encounters, Temple of the Snake God, coming out this June. Inside the box, you'll find a 100mm giant snake miniature, double-sided playmat, tokens, and adventure book to add into a Dungeons & Dragons 5e game. Inkling is a word card game coming this month from Osprey Games. Players put letter cards out in hopes other players can figure out the word being made. The cards have scribbling and imperfect lettering, so the cards could be played upside down, on their side, or overlapped. Plays in 20 minutes for 3 to 6 players, will retail for $24. A big announcement from Z-Man Games is that the classic game Carcassonne is getting a 20th anniversary edition coming soon. The new version brings a new look, better artwork, and new gameplay. The tiles will have a high-gloss UV spot print, as well as new illustrations and stickers to decorate the meeples. The game will include 87 land tiles, 17 river tiles, 40 meeples, 5 abbots. Plays 2 to 5 players in 30 to 45 minutes, and the edition will retail for $49.99. From WizKids, two new games were just announced to come out this August. First is Zombie Princess, where the princess is a zombie and hunts the knights, instead of the typical story of knights saving the princess. Players will place and move tiles to create a maze for their knight to get a key and get to the middle of the maze. Knights caught by the zombie princess turn into a zombie as well and begin hunting the other knights. Plays in under an hour for 2 to 5 people ages 10 and up. Expected retail is $39.99. The second game from WizKids is called Free Radicals, a 30-minute game for 2 to 5 players about controlling factions to unlock secrets of the sphere. The sphere is a mysterious structure holding advanced technology. Each faction players control have different game mechanics, goals, and driving philosophy, so very highly asymmetric. Will retail for $59.99. A new game in the Raccoon Tycoon series is coming out called Lizard Wizard. Designed by Glenn Drover, it features action selection, set collection, and auctioning as players compete to gather resources to cast spells, summon familiars to explore dungeons for gold and treasure, recruit wizards, and build magical towers. For 1 to 5 players and will retail for $49.99. Games Workshop has developed a new miniatures board game called Warhammer Quest Cursed City. While set in the Warhammer universe, this is designed as a standalone game experience and allows the uninitiated to jump into that style of miniatures game. Maybe this will be many hobbyist board gamers' gateway game into Warhammer. Who knows? Pre-orders for the game start this weekend, but the MSRP has not been announced yet. Coming soon from Burnt Island Games is a prequel to their popular In the Hall of the Mountain King. Fall of the Mountain King will be on Kickstarter this June and takes place before the events of In the Hall of the Mountain King. More information will be announced in the coming months, but this looks like a promising entry. 2 to 5 players can play in about 90 minutes. The popular racing game Camel Up is getting a spin-off sequel called Camel Up Off-Season. It's a standalone game taking place after the racing season has ended and the camels resume their day jobs of helping merchants seek fortunes. Push your luck at many marketplaces to stack goods on their caravans. Don't overload and drop anything though. The game plays 3 to 5 players in 30 to 45 minutes. It's expected to release this summer. Blue Orange Games has two new games scheduled for release in the second quarter. First is Zoom in Barcelona, where players are photographers competing to take the best pictures, including 400 dragons hidden throughout the city. Take pictures of landmarks and iconic buildings. For 2-6 players and plays in 30 to 60 minutes, it will retail for $24.99 when it comes out in May. The other new game from Blue Orange is Spin Circus. Become performers in a show to do stage acts, randomized by a wheel. Roll a die and choose a weighted acrobat on an upright spinning wheel to move to another part of the wheel. The wheel then moves and points to another number. That's how far they move down a track. This is for ages 4 and up and plays 1-4 players. Releases in June for $19.99. The Meeple Mentor channel is part of the board game community, the Gateway Network, made up of great upcoming board game content creators. In this segment, I'll highlight one of the other great content creators part of the network. This week, let's meet Friday Night Games.
What's going on, everybody? I'm John.
And I'm Matt.
And we're Friday Night Games.
And we're here to talk to you about us.
So Matt and I are from Windsor, Ontario, Canada. We've been friends for the better part of 30 years. And a couple years ago, we decided that we were going to play board games and become content creators.
What were we thinking?
Weird life choices we make sometimes. Yeah. You can find us on Instagram at FridayNightGames_official, Twitter at FridayNightGMS, our website, FridayNight.games, and you can search for us on YouTube as well.
We release a podcast that goes down every Friday. Please check that out on all major streaming platforms. What we try to do is we try to take a theme related to the board game industry or board games in general, and we try to deep dive into that to make a fun and entertaining and, I don't know, just a great podcast altogether.
Yeah, we try to do more than, hey, we played this game and this is what we thought of it. We thought...
Although we do that on Wednesdays.
We do. we thought playing board games, we'd often get some good ideas of stuff to talk about afterwards that we thought it would be a good idea to maybe just bring that to the podcast platform. So check it out. We really enjoy making our podcasts, and we hope you enjoy them as much as we like making them.
As much as my mom, our number one fan. Actually, she doesn't even listen.
Anyway, I'm John.
And I'm Matt.
And we're Friday Night Games. Thanks again. Take care.
Go to www.thegatewaynetwork.com or check out the Gateway Network's Instagram to see more. For the Meeple Mentor channel, first, I want to say thank you to everyone who has subscribed to the channel because we recently qualified for YouTube monetization. It's definitely a milestone that I'm honored to reach, and I know a lot of YouTubers never make it that far. I never knew if it would happen for me because I just started this whole thing because I wanted to make helpful videos. Now that it has a chance to make pennies, that at least helps me explain to the wife why I should keep doing the channel. She's not a gamer in any sense. Jay and I are going full steam with our podcast and have several game designer interviews lined up. There's three we'll be doing very soon and another one that won't be done until the summer to line up with their Kickstarter campaign. We've been able to do some playtesting of prototype copies of a lot of these games and have enjoyed that, so getting to talk to the designers about them is just excellent. If you've been watching videos on the channel for a while, you're probably aware of the giveaway that was active for the past 3 weeks. The winner of Hadrian's Wall from Garpill Games is Mark from Georgia. Going right now is a giveaway on my Instagram for a copy of Vowel. Vowel will be on Kickstarter in a few weeks, and if funded, the winner gets a free copy with all the stretch goals. Since March was a month with 5 weeks, I put out a bonus tutorial video. This past Tuesday, I uploaded a tutorial for the Ravensburger Prospero Hall game, Disney Jungle Cruise Adventure game. It's a much lighter family game, but one that a lot of people are interested in. I thought it would be a good bonus tutorial without taking away from the heavier regular content. I hope you like it. I included my own suggested house rules in it as well. Talking about planned tutorials, I've got a number of them already made and scheduled. Thankfully, that puts me ahead of schedule so I don't get too overwhelmed. Lost Ruins of Arnak, Dinogenics, and Cloud Age are all complete and will be released on the normal schedule. Other games I'm working on are Outlive and Blood Rage. Thanks for tuning in to today's news update, and I appreciate your support. And remember to teach when you can, but always be learning. See you next time.